My name is Sergey Grinev. I work for Quanta Labs and Blue Wave. I'm the CTO and the head of research of Waterfall project, which is based on my PhD. I work in computer in software development for more than 15 years. One of the companies I was initial technical team member was acquired by one of the largest bank in US. In blockchain, I am 7 years. All of this time, I work in Ethereum-inspired ecosystem. And also, currently, I was invited to advise government of one of the countries in implementation of the digital economy, and in particularly Web3 part of it. So, what is Waterfall? In a nutshell, it is a very scalable and very decentralized smart contract platform. It was designed in a way to preserve all the good things which Ethereum brought to the blockchain ecosystem, but to boost performance into the by a couple of measurable parameters to the different levels. This is how crypto adoption works compared to internet adoption. So some sources say that it happens with the same speed. Some of them say that they basically that the crypto adoption goes faster, like this one. So to the left we can see the basically adoption in the countries in a percentage of the population and in an absolute numbers. There were many presentations before that which were showing positive trends. I can add to this that basically government are adopting Bitcoin as a legal tender, governments are accepting donations in crypto, governments are implementing specific regulation and taxation for crypto. So this also brings confidence that probably the trend will continue, but we are still learning, which is good. So I would like to go through key elements of mass adoption. Key element of mass adoption is scalability. Because, for example, Bitcoin was supposed to be a digital cash, but it has become like a store of value in this investment vehicle, etc. Ethereum was also supposed to be something different from what it is right now, and a big portion of this is actually scalability and not being able to address the mass adoption in the way it should be addressed. Of course, it is dependent on different other elements, but if technology is not able to handle the load associated with mass adoption, these things are becoming secondary. So it was a very easy one. Now, the more complicated one, decentralization. Because often, and even on these conferences, we have heard, and recently often I have heard a couple of times, that we shouldn't care about decentralization. So I wouldn't go deep into details while particular people are saying this, but basically, if there is no decentralization, it's not Web3. If decentralization is measured by entry requirements or by consensus rules, it could be either use case specific implementation, or it is kind of like an intermediary solution, which is kind of Web.2.8, Web.2.9, but not actually Web3. And also, when we are talking about decentralization, we should remember that it contributes significantly to the security of the system. So, when we are using words mass adoption and Web3 in the same sentence, we should be talking about scalability and decentralization. Because if there is no decentralization, then we shouldn't be thinking about all these decentralized technologies, because Web2 is working just fine. Recently, A16Z tweeted that we are entering the new year of decentralization, so probably the narratives will change a little bit soon. So, what Waterfall? Waterfall actually is addressing the issues I mentioned. It is very decentralized by design. It is very scalable, and it actually allows it solves the trade-off between scalability and decentralization. It is able to have millions of validators by consensus, and it has also very low node requirements, like 2 core CPU, 4 gigabytes of RAM. And I would like to go deeper to the part about hardware. So here you can see comparison with the three most popular protocols which are currently on the market. And I would like to ask you to raise the hand people who have at home the computer of the protocol one. Okay, one. Somebody else? Good. Okay, so let's do protocol number three. Who has such computer at home? One, two. Okay, two. So one and two, yeah, three, yeah, good. So I will not be asking about Waterfall, because if you bought a laptop in the past 10 years, the chances are very high that you will be able to run the node on it. I also would like to go to do a step further in this direction and suggest to compare our node requirements with smartphones. So basically, average smartphone right now has 2 to 4 times more CPUs and RAM than our node requirements. And we are already working on the concept to develop the nodes which will be run on cell phones. So with that being said, here is a comparison of Waterfall and pretty much all the popular layer one smart contract platforms on the market. We outperform each of them by at least one parameter of these four. We were not putting the names of them, but if you would like to get more details, you can always approach me and I can do, we can say, deeper explanation of each of these parameters for each of the examples here. So, why Waterfall? So, first of all, EVM. By some sources says that EVM depths are actually hold 80 to 90% of the market. So, 80 to 90% of the depths are EVM. Also, large community. Also, bridges. So basically, we develop decentralized bridges, which are at least multiple times more secure than the more centralized solutions. And again, I'm not going too technical here. If you are interested, you can approach me in private and I will explain. And also, yeah, it is scalable. So scalability can be compared and actually we can outperform Visa, MasterCard, UnionPay, and doing it, which are centralized networks, and we can do it on the decentralized layer one. So, thank you, yeah. So basically, long story short, we are able to, we are targeting the market which actually grows by itself, and we are going to take part of it and will grow with market and will grow because of the advantages we are having on the market. So basically the stage we are at, actually we are very close to the launch of the protocol. We are last weekend somebody sent 2 million of transactions to our testnet, and basically testnet handled it, and it actually had, yes, okay, yeah. So, yeah. Well, it was at 15. So, okay, but anyways, yeah. Okay,
then. We got the timer went wrong.
Yeah. So, yeah, thanks for listening. We recently received strategic investment, which have done full technical due diligence, and we are preparing for the launch in Q1. The rest you can get from me in private. Thank you.
Thank you.